c'est prêt. Rends les choses faciles et sèche-moi ces larmes de crocodile.
So I promised on my my intro part of this long, extended, long-winded video. I do talk a lot. Sorry about that. I did promise that I would do a review of my new DeWalt tile saw. I know these are not a new thing at all. People have been using them for years and years. People, for the most part, you know, give good reviews on it. I've never had one. As I said on my other video, I got a new DeWalt saw. I'll link that at the bottom. That's the unboxing video. As I said on there, I was kind of married to Tile-Matic, which became Husqvarna, which still has saws out there. The Husqvarna is quite pricey at over $1,000. There's a couple of sister models of that Husqvarna. It's the same makeup, it's belt-driven motor. There are a couple of sister models that they make also. There are other brand, not other brand, but other names under that name. But anyway, I have never had a Husqvarna. In fact, I've never had a brand new tile saw unless it was one of those little table ones which you would use for like mosaics in a kitchen or something like that. So I've used this now for a couple of days, and if you watched the other video, the unboxing one where I got the new one, I was borrowing my friend's and the motor was really loud. My Husqvarna was pretty loud too. That just seemed extraordinarily loud, and then you know, I kind of mentioned on there, it's probably the bearings, and because it's a very old saw, he had actually bought that used and now has had it for, what, 7 years? And so, you know, it's seen its better days. But this is a brand new saw with a brand new motor, brand new blade. One of the things I mentioned on the other video, too, I don't like these cutouts on the blade. And I mentioned on that video that I was going to toss this, but because I'm on this job, I'm going through a very soft tile, natural stone, I'm not too concerned about it, but I'm definitely gonna, on the next job, I'm gonna dump this and get a different one. This will end up being a spare blade, emergency blade, if you will. The reason I don't like it is because it gives. There's just enough give on here, if you can see it close up. When I'm doing a very, very hard tile, which I do mostly on porcelain, this blade gives more than the tile does. And I've just had experience before, not with this particular brand blade, but with the little notch outs that they have on some blades, that the blade will bend enough to where I'll have an uneven cut, which is unintentional, and then I'll have to do it again and again. And anyway, I just gave up on using these notched blades, so I'm going to take that off. But anyway, getting back to what I was talking about before I rudely interrupted myself, I like it. End result is I like it. There's a lot of things I like about it. Look how far back I am. I can do a 24, I put a 24 inch tile on here, which I'm doing now, and I still have another 4 or 5 inches left over. So I don't have the extended table attachment that my Husqvarna has. Somebody had mentioned that it's almost waterless as far as dumping water, and I don't agree with that. Even though it has this back tray, and this back tray just kind of locks in on itself, and if you can see that, it kind of dumps the water, the excess water up here, and then it just kind of rolls back again into the tray, which I do like, but it is kind of large and cumbersome. They could have cut this in half. It didn't have to be this long, and maybe the slope could have been a little bit higher, but that's a small potato type of thing. The other thing I noticed too, I don't necessarily want to use this extended table portion. Yes, I would have a need for it at some point, but it just kind of sits off to the side mostly since I've been using it. And without that extended table portion, if you can see, the table almost lines up to the tray down there. So when you have a tile that's sitting over this edge, which I've been doing quite a bit of, then water comes off of the tile, water comes off of the tray and down onto the floor, and the only way to stop it is to use this. But you can't use this unless you put that on. So I don't know, it's not a big deal again, because my Husqvarna didn't even have this, and so I just put a sponge on my tile and hoped for the best, and I had a little water spillage. But my tray with the Husqvarna set a little bit more into the table, so I didn't really have that issue as much as I did with this one. Putting this on there kind of cuts down on the water, the excess water drippage, because it's just going to all funnel down and channel down back into the tray again. But if you can see from the top, this is kind of a large setup. It's a large setup because of these, the back tray and this side tray over here. It's not that I don't like the saw overall. There's a lot of features, as I said before, that I really, really, really like. It's going to be my go-to saw from here on out. And any other saws that I have currently, I'll just go ahead and set those in my storage. And if this breaks down or something happens, then those will be my backup saws. So I do like this. As I mentioned before, I'm not going to go too much into more talking about it, but you know, it has this knob here for the depth, so you can actually decide the depth of your tile. It has this back locking, where's it at, this back locking mechanism, so that you can actually do a 22.5 or to 45 if you wanted to, which cuts down on a lot of hassle making those type of cuts, which is really cool. That's one of the features that I like the best, actually. It's got this little brush guard here, which, you know, catches sometimes sediments of tile, but it also catches water and all that stuff and drops it back down. And then it's got this big flap in the back. Actually, it's a trifold type of flap, and I do like that. It doesn't catch all the water, obviously, or you wouldn't need that, but it does a pretty good job of it. What else? So my other tray with my Husqvarna, I would have to dump a 5-gallon bucket times almost two, about 1.5 to 1.75 a bucket to fill up my tray, or to get to the point, you know, where it's at the line. With this one, I can barely get 5 gallons in here. It's about 4.5 gallons because they've recessed this part of the tray so deep. It's probably, what, 2-3 inches? It's about 3 inches recessed deep so that my water pump fits in there nicely. And there's enough water in here with this recess all the way around that I'm not going to run out of water anytime soon. And therefore, I don't have to use as much. So if I dump my water right now, and I'm at level, if I dump my water right now, I would not even quite fill up a 5-gallon bucket. So that I really like. I mentioned before, if they could have integrated some type of halogen light in here. I have a clamp-on light that I use, and I'll eventually use this when it's, you know, I'm doing in low lighting or the dark or whatever. But if they had integrated a light into the blade somewhere up under here or something like that, that would have been excellent. That would have been, I guess, my biggest complaint about this, is because my other saw, you didn't have this guard so much in the way so you could actually see your blade. Again, a lot of my critique on this is very small potatoes. You know, overall, I still like it, and I will still use it as my go-to saw. And I just thought, now that I've used it, I would give my little follow-up review on it. So there you go. And now back to the tile. Part of the new saw, and this applies to all wet saws, not just this one in particular, the blade doesn't really hurt your fingers. If I turn it on, and I think I have a couple other videos that show where, you know, I'm slowing the blade down by holding it like that. This is a diamond type of wet saw blade. It's actually cooled by water, but it's little diamond bits on it, if you can see it or not. So that's meant to be for very porous, harder surfaces. It's not meant for soft surfaces. So the harder the surface, like if you had a brick or a block or something like that, it would go through it like a hot knife through butter. And then the more dense the surface, like with the tile that I'm working with now, is very dense, and so it slows it down a little bit. But you know, the more dense the material, the more it'll go through it. It doesn't go through soft materials. If I try to cut a piece of wood on here, it would fail. If I try to cut my finger, it would also fail. Yes, you can damage your hand on it if it got caught up in there like that and got caught up. Yeah, you could do some definite damage, but as far as cutting your fingers or something like that, it's not going to happen. Still, you know, adhere to safety issues and stuff like that. So, as I said, you know, using this saw for the first time, I really like a lot of the features that it has on it that my other one doesn't have, with the 45s and the tilts and all that stuff, as well as being able to change out the blade easily. And you'll notice I haven't changed out the original DeWalt blade, but I will eventually. I don't like, as I said before, I don't like those little cutouts there. That eventually will give me problems on a more denser tile. But another thing I've used it on before is cutting glass tile specifically, and other types of glass, as I did with this. And you can see it's a pretty smooth cut. So this is a Starbucks bottle that I actually literally cut in half. And, you know, it's a pretty smooth, it's a little bit rough on the edges of here or whatever. But if you were really, I don't know what they call a Starbucks fan, a Buckeye. No, that would be Ohio. You could actually integrate that into a tile, say a mosaic and a backsplash or something, and have your Starbucks bottle kind of recessed in, which would be kind of cool. And there are beer drinkers out there that would enjoy a Corona, or at least the bottle of a Corona, inside of their shower, somehow integrated into the design. So let me kind of show you how this works. If you see now, it's basically the same as a Starbucks bottle. You have half a bottle or three quarters of one or whatever, and there is a little chip on the side inadvertently that I did. It was sitting too close to the edge here, so there is a chip, but you could actually set that into a tile design that you had of your choice. And you could probably actually, if you had it waterproofed in the back, you could actually pour some yellow liquid in there and act as if you had a beer sitting in your shower. So that's another cool idea. One idea I did a while back, this friend of mine had actually attended a college where their mascot, I don't know if it's a mascot, was a nautilus. And the closest thing I could come to a nautilus was one of these conch shells. And what I had done for her, didn't cut my finger. So take two, I finally got it. This is basically, what, a quarter of an inch wide, which is about the size of most tile. And then you could recess this in with tile surrounding it and then grout all this area in. And then what you see is the outside edge of this circular pattern. So just another little idea. I don't know about the beer bottle thing. It wouldn't be my thing, but you could possibly do that. But there's a lot of different design ideas that you can make on your own. And being able to cut with a tile saw will facilitate a lot of those ideas that you might have.